Hello, this is Xbox Ahoy, and these are the weapons of modern warfare. In this episode, we're taking a look at the knife. The knife is one of two melee weapons in the game, making its fifth appearance in the series, and is unlocked right from the start. Invented by early hominins in the Paleolithic era, some 2.6 million years ago, they were very simple cutting edges made of sharp stone or flint. By Neolithic time, stone blades were polished and fitted with crude handles made of wood or animal hide, which protected the user's hand. Having gone through one or two modifications since then, the knife's purposes have largely been unchanged, suitable for cutting through various objects and materials, as well as being used for its original purpose, of delivering a killing strike on your target. Though soldiers of the modern era are typically issued a combat knife such as the American K-Bar, the model shown in-game is a Tatang combo edge knife, the same model used in Modern Warfare 2, as well as the throwing knife for both games. The Tatang is a fixed blade design, manufactured from the Masters of Defense knife company, Blackhawk, and was designed by Edge Weapons expert, Michael Janich. The Tatang employs the savage cutting power of a traditional Filipino burong, only in a leaner, more versatile package. The knife features a pistol grip for greater reach and increased chopping power, and a partially serrated edge for those cutting jobs that might require something extra. The blade is larger than your typical combat knife, measuring in at 8.6 inches, and made of 1085C high carbon steel, with a thermoplastic rubber handle for improved grip, even under wet conditions. Although typically used as an auxiliary weapon when you find your ammo depleted or caught between reloads, the knife can be devastatingly effective up close, dealing 135 damage to your foe if your strike connects. This means that only one hit from your knife will deal a lethal blow to any part of the body, with only a couple exceptions. If your enemy is using either Juggernaut Point Streak, it can take up to 8 slashes from your knife to deplete their 1000 health points. Another exception, though much more rare, can occur where the knife will only grant you a hit marker, such as when your enemy falls into the Final Stand or Dead Man's Hand death streaks, where they are granted invincibility for the duration of their short descent to the ground. Aside from these rare occurrences, your knife will prove to instantly kill your enemy in one swift stroke in both core and hardcore game modes. It will take much longer to draw your weapon after knifing than in previous Call of Duty titles, and also has the shortest effective range to date at an anemic 32 inches. Though the knife is limited to strictly short range engagements, it can prove to be a viable option if your primary weapon suffers at short range. If you find yourself in a close quarters combat situation with a gun not suitable for the task, such as a sniper rifle or light machine gun, the knife may very well be your best option of attack. If stealth is your thing, the knife can be a very useful tool, as you will not show up on your enemy's radar and is quieter than even a silenced firearm. Should you be in a situation where remaining undetected is key, the utilization of your knife could prove to be vital. Though the knife is typically reserved for specific encounters, its role in your arsenal can be greatly bolstered should you choose to do so. The melee proficiency is available for all SMGs and shotguns, increasing the speed at which you melee by about 33%. Should you require an even greater increase in melee speed, the use of the tactical knife attachment is unlocked at weapon level 7 on each pistol, and allows the player to knife at about double its original speed. Should you require faster melee still, the Akimbo USP-45s boast an even faster melee animation than the tactical knife, just as it did in Modern Warfare 2. The selection of your perk loadout can also be used for greater integration of a more knife-focused strategy. Extreme Conditioning gives the user double the default sprint time, with the Pro variant granting the ability to vault over obstacles at a quicker pace. This will allow you to close the gap between you and your target, as the effective range of your knife requires you to be in close proximity of your enemy. However, if your plan of attack includes the addition of throwing knives, Scavenger may be a useful perk as well, to replenish your small supply without having to retrieve them at their terminal position. As far as your second perk slot goes, Assassin will grant you extra stealth, enabling you to sneak up on your foes while remaining off their radar. For your third perk, I recommend the use of Dead Silence, for quiet footsteps, removing any audio cues of your forthcoming attack. For the best primary weapon of your knife-based strategy, I recommend using an SMG or shotgun, as these will grant you 100% speed. For those looking for an added edge and speed, I suggest the use of the USAS 12 shotgun for your primary, as this will grant you 75% increase in speed, as does the MP9 and Scorpion machine pistols. Combine this with the effects of extreme conditioning, and the user will be able to sprint for unparalleled distances. The knife suits far better for more cautious and stealthy playstyles, as a more aggressive approach can prove counteractive, as you need to be within very close proximity of your enemy to be effective. However, since the knife does not need to be selected and can be summoned instantly with a touch of a button, the user can be selective when they deem the knife to be the best mode of attack. The knife is a devastatingly effective weapon, needing only to touch your enemy once for them to meet their demise. While it is unmatched against any gun within its effective range, outside of its short range, you are virtually unarmed, so be sure to use it at the appropriate times. With a healthy dose of awareness and plenty of caution, the knife can be utilized as a close quarters powerhouse. Doing so is just a matter of mitigating risks. Be sure to stay clear from wide open parts of maps and making every encounter close quarters and on your own terms. By sticking to low traffic areas of maps, you will lessen the chance of encountering multiple enemies at a time, as doing so while knifing will result in an asymmetrical fight where your chances of survival can be abysmal. With good reaction time and knowing when to utilize, the knife can be integrated into absolutely any playstyle. Although its effective range is smallest out of any weapon, nothing quite measures up to it in close combat. With a long history and many uses, this ancient tool will leave you a cut above the rest. This has been Xbox Ahoy. Join me next time where we go over the Stinger Rocket Launcher. Until then, farewell.